This week we'll talk about Pilu, it's Parshas Emor. Try to condense it, to summarize it. Pilu, it's as a mahalach. That Ruach says, Em omdem lispal ele metoch koivet rosh. What does that mean? It almost says a person when you're daven, as we live by Lamatu, Ein of Lamalu. The Tfilah Atzmo, Nachum Otsim, Shekol Mitzvah, every mitzvah is set up in three phases. There's the Machshuva, there's the Dibbe, and there's the Masa. So we'll take for example, that the Shesh Mitzvah Tmidius, that a person has to remember the Baruch Shalom every second, the Siyid, so that's a Mitzvah Machshuva. You have Mitzvahs with the Birim, so that's a Limud HaTorah. You have Mitzvahs with Masim, so that's Anuchas Tefillin, Lemasham. But Chassidish HaSfura, Baal Shem Tov HaKadosh HaMagid came along, and said that every Mitzvah has to be also Machshuva, also Dibben, also Masim. If we only make one of them, there's something missing to the mitzvah. The question is, what's something missing to the mitzvah, and how do you make mitzvahs that's only in machshuva? How do you do that in masa? How do you do that in dibbe, and etc.? The Baal Shem Tov HaKadosh explains, that's what the Piyut is talking about, that everything that a person does here on this world, anything that's missing for someone here on this world, is actually, it's not what's hurting him, that's the problem. It's something much deeper, if you call it Shechina betachtoinim tzoyach gevoya. When there's something missing from the Shechina here on this world, it's actually Kodesh giving you, as we say, a lack, not a lack of what Kodesh Baruch Hu is missing from us in that world. What does that mean? Kodesh Baruch Hu created the world in order that we should see Him. Achvoidi Berusev, Yitzartev Afasisev. He created the world in order that we Amzi Yitzartev Li, Tilusi Yisapari, like the Ramban says. Einer Yitzhufiz Betachtoinim, Akvahoidis Lai. Bush used to say, Kodesh Baruch Hu is waiting very over 5,000 years that we should see Him. He gave us Mesa Migdash, tried all kinds of methods. In the meantime, he had patience, but now he's starting to lose his patience, he used to say. So actually what we're talking about is this epidemic, as we call it. It's, everybody is busy. Where did it come from? Who did it? Who's the blame? The Chinese, it's the Shulam, it's this Rusha, that Rusha. Nobody even thinks a second that that means for him something. But everybody has some uncomfortable matzum. If it's uncomfortable, if it's pain, if it's the place that he doesn't want to be now, and he has to be there, etc. The person has to know that Kodesh Baruch Hu wants to elevate you, not to punish you. He wants you to feel His tzar, since Klal Yisrael is the only one that Imai Elcha Bitzur, Noichi Eredim, Noichi Elchu Gam Uroi, it's called a tanug of the whole world, is that there should be a Nevuim, and the Nevuim should give Shvach for the Boyer. So whenever there's missing that Shvach, Zakadosh Baruch Hu wants to elevate me, that I should recognize Him in this whole story. That means I use the mushul that I suffer and my leg hurts from time to time. So you go to a doctor and a doctor puts on some cream there, or terrain, whatever you call it. But if it doesn't go through, so you go to an orthopedic and he says make an MRI and he finds that it's the lower back that's the problem. So he starts giving you all kinds of pain and painkillers. or doesn't go by, so you come to a chiropractor and he says, no, it's not the, it's not the back, it's up there in the shoulders. And he starts giving all kinds of zets in the shoulders. And you go to a Chinese doctor and he says, no, it's all the way up. You have to put in needles in the ear and the eyes and the nose. So you come to the bush, you come to this derech, and he starts saying, it's up here. That means just like you go to a doctor, a plain doctor, and you will always see the problem locally, not globally. The same thing is Avodas Hashem, because Baruch Hu wants us, that we see every problem is not something global, not something Pratib B'Shulcha, it's something more. Because Baruch Hu wants to reveal himself to you, and he, since you are the one, Klal Yisroel are the one that can see deeper from behind what's hiding more than anybody in the world. So actually it's Avo, Ve'uli Moshiyim V'Hartziyim. Moshiyim means the ones that do not take it personal, and know that it's not only I don't take it personal, but I know it's something like a schir. Zuchu nasle samchaim, loinus rachle samumis. Person learns Torah. He can learn Torah in two ways. He can learn Torah for the knowledge of the Torah. He can learn Torah because the Torah actually connects me to the Rebbeinu Shleim. So what's the difference? The difference is zuchu or loy zuchu. Zuchu can be purified. Zuchu can mean it's a merit that the Kodesh Baruch Hu gives me the Torah. But a person who goes to the Torah, that actually he's giving the schiz for the Rebbeinu Shleim, that he's learning the Torah, nobody else is learning Torah like me. Or he doesn't feel his shiftless, that he needs the Torah to purify. All he's into the knowledge of the Torah, how to give it over and how to express it and how to do it, etc. It's limud haTorah. But you didn't get to the shorish. Why Kodesh Baruch Hu gave the Torah, why Kodesh Baruch Hu created the world through the Torah and made such a world that everything looks like it's Teva, and he wants you to live in Allah Teva and know that the Kodesh Baruch Hu wants you to live with him. And the more you don't understand, the more you go into a minah, that's the Nachasiach, Tzadik Ve'Menusa Yichya. That's what the Nachasiach we give for Rebbeinu Shleim in the whole creation of the world. So if a person learns Torah and he feels that it's Zuchu, Zuchu that means it comes to purify him. Zuchu that means he b'chal has a schiz that he can learn Torah because Baruch Hu gave it to him. And he understands Tachlis HaYedir Da'at She'en Yodea. He believes that whatever he understands, at the end of the day he doesn't understand it. At the end of the day, he's Einem Musa. You can't get to understand what the Rebbeinu Shleim is. So, but why the Kodesh Baruch Hu give it in a way that we do understand? Why the Kodesh Baruch Hu give it in a way that we figure out something? And now we're in a world you can't figure anything out. Now whatever you had a problem, they told you figure it out. Now there's no more figuring out. Nobody can figure it out. People are breaking heads. They come up this way, that way. They're checking out hundreds of medication and hundreds of all kinds of charts and trying a here, trying a here, whatever they try. They can't figure it out. But actually, in a minute, that's called you figure it out. That Kodesh Baruch Hu doesn't want you to figure it out. That Kodesh Baruch Hu wants you to come to Tachas HaYedir Einyadeh. That means from one side he gave you the Das to figure out things. He gave you the Seichel to understand things. But he gave you the Seichel for that much that you should understand that you don't understand. Tachas HaYedir Da'at She'en Yodea. As Fasemus calls it, you have a Bechir that you don't have a Bechir. And the whole thing that states for the person is the roots that he wants to get close to the Rebbeinu Shleim, but in order to want to get close to the Rebbeinu Shleim, he understands that he has to be mafka himself for the Rebbeinu Shloim, because if as long as he's going to keep a grip on his understanding, he's not going to get there. That means, it's, I always say, a mushla, it's like a person is on a horse and a wagon, and they tell him just throw away the mushkot, they call it in English, and let the horse go where he wants to. But a person is afraid to do that. My shver l'rashulam was in Siberia, and one day he got lost in the woods with a horse, and he didn't know where, how to get out of it. So Kodesh Baruch Hu gave him the das, just leave off, let the horse go where he wants to. And the horse itself found a way out of the woods and went to the house. And he says, that's actually what Kodesh Baruch Hu wants you to do. That whenever you, from one side, whenever you understand to do something, you have to try your best, you have to do your maximum that you can. You can't say, Rebbeinu Shloim, do it for me. But from the other side, when you come to a dead end, that Eloi know that you can't figure it out, that actually comes to teach you, just like you can't figure out how to do this, he also wants you to know that actually what you think you can figure out, it's Rebbeinu Shloim giving you the koich to figure it out. So when a person learns Torah in such a way, is actually that's the key in Bias Olam. Then he comes to the recognize that Kodesh Baruch is on this world, which that means I'm using my knowledge that I don't have knowledge. I'm losing my knowledge that I'm bounded with my knowledge. The knowledge that I have cannot come any give any masiga give. I cannot come all the way through. When a person learns like that, so actually that brings the Geila, that means Nivna Besa Migdash Biyuma. But actually what he wants. Now a person has to know every mitzvah. Every tefillah, he has to do it mitoch koy v'drosh. Koy v'drosh means that, as I said before, my foot hurts, but I'm busy. A doctor tells me it's the back, but I'm busy with my foot. Another doctor tells me it's the shoulders, but I'm busy with my foot. Another doctor tells me, knows the eyes, I'm busy with my foot. Comes the spinker and tells you, there's the Shechina, but I'm busy with my food. That means as long as I'm not going to get to the shoresh from the problem, we're not going to solve the problem. We should say everybody has his weakness. Everybody, his weakness wakes up in a certain place. People start stuttering, people have a backache, people start the eyes, all kinds of tics. This all actually happens once he goes into stress. As long as the person is not in stress, then the system, the blood, runs through the whole system, and wherever the weakness of a person is, gets a bigger supply of blood than the places that are not in the weakness. But once a person gets tense, then everything gets narrow, all the arteries become narrow, then the blood that has to go through till the place of the weakness, it's not going through. So the now you have all kinds of ways how to treat it. So either you put on something Voltaren, whatever it is to take away the pain, but the arteries are still narrow, and the blood doesn't go through. Or you take an aspirin. When your head hurts, which actually comes also from stress, but what does aspirin do? Since we find a way how to cross out, not to get to the Munchlin, not to get to the source of it, we take aspirin. So the aspirin makes the blood thinner, and now the blood can go through, even though it's thinner arteries. But again, we didn't solve the problem, because the aspirin wears out after an hour or two, and then you have to take another aspirin. But the right way is to come to the source of the problem is the stress. And the stress is also not what's stressing me right now. If it's money, if it's health, whatever it is, that's not the stress. The stress is a Kodesh Baruch Hu, Kam Yuchu, is giving you his ke'ev, his pain that we don't see him. So once I understand that the pain that I have is nothing that actually this Hashem wants me to connect him, to daven to him and tell him, Atochone Ludum Das. I took my Das for myself. That's why I don't have right now the Das. I took my Panusa for myself, and that's why I don't have now Panusa. But it's not that he doesn't want to give me Panusa, not that he doesn't want to give me Refia. He wants to give me Refia, but he wants that we should know that he's the one that gives it. So actually, what is daven? Daven is identifying that the problem is not, so we can daven two ways. You can daven the person asks what's missing him, what he's failing, but then he didn't come to the tachlis of the failure. It's also davening, but it's just like taking something to pass by and not get to the source of it. Then it ka ein of lematru velibo lemalo. When a person davens, he has to know that I'm right, that I'm busy about my foot hurting. You can get around with it. But if you want to do it the right way is to get to understand and there's much a deeper meaning of what's missing. Kodesh Baruch Hu wants you with him together. So that, then a person is davening such a way, and on the lispal eila mitoch koivedrosh means that it's the COVID that I have is not in my foot, not in my back, and not in my shoulders. It's Rosh. Rosh, that means actually all the way, go all the way up till the place where it is. That's called Esaisa de Lesata. Then actually I pinpointed, I got to the source of the problem. As once I get to there, that brings a very big simchan all the oilaments. Then it comes Esaisa de Lesata, then comes Esaisa de Laila, then automatically everything opens up. That's what we started saying. You need machshuva, you need diva, you need masa. So we asked, how do we do by davening? Where machshuva I can understand, diva I understand, but masa understanding. So some say that masa is akimas fusa have a masa. Our Shem Tov HaKodesh, let's explain that we're talking about altogether something else. We are now in an oilam which is called oilam asiya, which is called oilam hamasa. In Kabul it's called the makom from the nefesh. And there's oilam hadiba. Oilam hadiba, that's called ruach, that's the lev, that's the regashot, that's the emotions. So once a person connects to emotions, he connected to an inner place, that means the tension that's closing him up. Then you have an oilam which is called machshuva, that's called neshuma. That means you're going all the way up to the source which HaKadosh Baruch Hu created the world, that HaKadosh Baruch Hu kai neshuma shasati to hoilahi. A person is a chelik lekai mimal. Actually, when you daven, you're not only davening about your backache, you're not only davening for your stress, for the chubas hadas, you're davening for the source that HaKadosh Baruch Hu actually close the shefa, not because he wanted to close the shefa, as he wanted me to notice that he's here, and once I notice that he's here, that brings a big happiness, just like a child comes home to the father. And the father is very happy. The same thing is, once a person davens in such a way, or does a mitzvah in such a way, that's goyim simcha bel yoinim. So a person has to start believing in himself. Believing in himself is, says the tzudik, just like a person has to believe in the Ribono Shleilam, you have to believe in yourself. What does that mean? You have to believe in yourself, but I can start doing stupid things. No, believing in yourself means believing in a Kodesh Baruch Hu. That means that you are actually here, you're the ambassador of the Ribono Shleilam, you're the one that a Kodesh Baruch Hu wants you, and any problem that you are, he's asking you right now, giving you a phone call called ringtones these days. You got a ringtone, that who's the ringtone behind that? You have to pick up the phone and speak. Once you pick up the phone, so I'm trying to call, so I say, you're trying to go to your phone 7 o'clock to get me. Once you got me, it brings simcha, but as much simcha it brings you, it brings me even more simcha that I can give it over now. So I see there's acceptance, I see there's wanting, I see there's it's kosher to hear. It's chakaviyuch v'abon shloim is aina moshul doimon animshun. The Kodesh Baruch Hu yoyse ma'asha aigul yoyse linik, hapur yoyse lahaynik. The Kodesh Baruch Hu Kola, the whole Bias HaOlam was Ein Melech B'loi Om. Because Baruch Hu created the whole world, He's Ati Ach Shaloi Nivro Olam, Ati Mishonivro Olam. Ani Hashem Loi Shinisi, the whole thing that He created the world is Olam Chesed Yibuna. He wanted we should be in such a place that we can go around and not look in His direction. We can go around and think, Kol Yechivoy Tzimid, Yisra Sachai Lazeh, I can live in denial, or I come to the Bechir that I don't have a Bechir, and actually Kodesh Baruch Hu is forcing me to see Him. Once you live in such a way, that is being stunning to Kodesh Baruch Hu. Marti v'nasa v'tzoyni. Marti means that I asur mamuras nevo v'olam. That means I created the world. Tzimtzum acha tzimtzum. And I put you in such a place that you might think that you are the creator of the world. And in the meantime, you understand and you notice from your pain that actually Kodesh Baruch Hu doesn't want to hurt you, doesn't want to missing anything, just the opposite. He wants to bring you a meaning into life that you should understand that you have to see Kodesh Baruch Hu not only what's missing, but even what's not missing is also not your source from Kodesh Baruch Hu. That brings actually a simcha. And that actually is a simcha in this world. That is actually the sphere soime. You seek on ma, she pogamte the sphere. Ma, that's called hachnua. The more a person says sphere soime, what is sphere soime? Actually, the first night of Pesach, we got out of Mitzrayim, because Baruch Hu brought us to a place that it takes all the people 40 years to get there, but then He took it away. Now, we want to go back to that. So every day that we understand that I don't have it, and all the middos, 7 weeks, 7 days, which is all the middos, then we can come back to the Kabbalah Satorim, Nae Punem El Punem, Punem El Punem Dibur Hashem. Then we can come to the other, that we know that anything that's happening, anything that I see and anything that I understand, I don't understand, but I do have a minna to see the Rabban Shem is behind all of this. Baruch Hashem, we should have atzlocha, we should be able to be after all of this balagan here, but we have to know that right now we have to take out the best that we can out of it, which brings in this humbleness, hanuva, shulem, apelis, after, brings koichas hanefesh, which we wouldn't have gotten without going through this. Baruch Hashem, we should be able to schiz from Pshimen, kudarai Pshimen, lismu chula b'shahas adchak. Baruch Hashem, give everybody his koich, his moich, Buna, Chaya, Mizoyna, whatever a person needs should have more than he needs and be able to help others, and shouldn't need anyone to help you in that situation. Thank you for listening.